Hello, everyone. Okay, there we go. All right, so, just in case if you guys are on, watching right now, or watching this later, this is a lot of just random stuff that I'm trying to do here today, because it is mostly on testing the setup, testing how things go, also playing a practice game live. I've been having a lot of struggles when it comes to getting these games recorded recently, and I thought I had it down. Then, of course, I get another curveball, so whatever. Roll with the punches, and let's go with it. So, hopefully the mic, this headset's working. Ideally, if I'm going to be doing a tournament, like the CAC tournament coming up, so campaign against Kenneth Singer, sign up. Please, sign up. What we're taking a look at here is, you know, we're going to have a full-time commentator, just like Gold Squadron Podcast, all those other ones. It's going to be another gentleman, because I'll be TOing and I'll be jumping in and out, so he's going to have this. But we're gonna test some fun stuff. Hopefully it's streaming well. Looks like it is. It's green on my screen. I'm just going to either try and run this until I can break it, or get into this game, because it's league playoffs and we are in the semifinals. So, really hope, and I actually made it, this time, so I'm really excited about that. I'm really excited to be this far. It's my first time making the playoffs in the league, this league, actually, really any league, well, except Vassal ones, but, in-person leagues, this is my first one. So, I'm just gonna kinda go do a rundown of all the screens I got available for a live screen now. Again, trying to break it. Let me know. Hopefully everything stays connected. And then also, just like, if you guys like it, if you guys hate it, I want to hear from you. And we'll go from there. And then otherwise, I'll just kind of play a fun game, a practice one. I'm trying something terribly different. I'm playing the bad guys, which, as many of you know, I don't play bad guys, but I think this will be good against one list in particular. It's not a hard counter, and it's starting to play my play style with, like I am with resistance. It just has a little more team synergy that I like, which is kind of cool. So, alright, we're going to go through these. Not the welcome, the standby screen, you guys have seen those. They're on the, when I'm on my desktop. This is on my laptop. Which I use for for recording X-Wing games and other board games, hopefully here in the future, like Guild Ball and Legion. I run it with my CNC machine. And this is what I'd call the commentator screen. So again, the commentator, me or whoever, is going to jump to this screen, more one-on-one. I might fill this up later with more details and stuff, but as of right now, I got it set up for one mic, maybe two here. But then let's get to the fun stuff.
Okay. Commentator mic on. Me.
Okay, because I'm really close. I got to turn off that dice tray mic, so I apologize about that going off. Actually, let's see how that works. So here, hold on.
Okay. So you might be hearing me through the dice tray mic right now, which is working properly. Yes! Alright, I'm going to turn that off.
Okay. Alright, so for right now, we're just going to do it this way. I'll switch probably to the dice tray mic in a little bit and take this off. But seems to be that the dice are coming in pretty good. Visible. It's getting an evade die. Nice. Okay, so blank. All right, so the standard dice are coming in great. It's tough. I got to figure out what is the best optimal background chrome one. It might be a purple, but I think I'm using a gold yellow color as of right now. All right. So we got, okay, and these are the practice lists that I'm seeing right now. So it's the boo-boo. I want to, there's a good chance this is the person. So they're currently in the top left. They are all the way in the back, to the back left of the map there. I'm all the way in the back right. And then, so this is what you guys have seen before, standard. I actually have the first player token now, so, you know, that's going to be how this game goes. I have more points. I got to get that. Ah, okay, so, cool. I have to get the points that the player has scored on here. So, that's already something I found, which is great. I'm glad that I'm finding these things. Okay, so I will work on that after the stream. I will make sure that the points are visible during the match. And I will make a note of that. Okay. Alright, so then this is my new camera setup. Okay, so this is what... let me get these dice out of here. This is my overhead cam dice tray. So I can, as I'm in the middle of a game, say for some reason someone's stuff is kind of in the way, I can at least remove them. So you can see in the bottom right now corner of the screen, I got that player. Alright, so we got the boo-boo in the bottom right, and then you got my list in the bottom left here. So, it's just the simple webcam, one of those Logitech ones. That's my dice tray cam also, and then I got another one. That's the one that I use when I'm recording live. It is amazing how bright that thing is. So, I'm kind of enjoying this right now. I think that's pretty cool. What I'll have to do, actually, what I'll, hey, you know what? Okay, so this is why this is called good troubleshooting. I have to flip it. Did not want to do that. Default. Transform. That didn't do anything. Oh, maybe because I actually had this locked. Alright. Oh, there we go. Weird. Okay, there we go. That's it. That's what we're looking at. So, if I actually have this set up, right? That should be what it is. I need the right player. Okay, so, again, is why I'm doing this. So I appreciate everyone sticking around, watching this kind of stuff. I think this is kind of neat. So, like I said, if you see anything stupid, also if I'm coming in clear or not. All right. To work this in later. It's for the card portion, so. Okay, so I realized all that I said was there. So what was going on is I was actually trying to check to see the list. That's going to be a feature. I got to add the mic in there. So I'll work on that. So that's another thing I got to jot down. But basically what I was shown is I can show a list, show a card on that list. Again, this is all from the stream tabletop DO web feature, which, you know, if things are going crazy, I can always set up some other things, such as show the dice if we can't see it for some reason, like if the dice tray isn't working. But yeah, I've been having some issues, so that's why I'm very happy about how this is coming along. So, all right. I don't see any reason not to. But I'm thinking it's just time to get into this random game to practice. Like I said, I'm just kind of practicing here. I don't know what's going on there. Okay, so we are not at that place right now. We are here. Yes, that is the 9Q text. I got that going. Base game. Alright, hey, okay, so look, this would be the farewell one. So like I said, I'm gonna have what I want it to be is text files. Apparently not open that up. Ooh, but we're gonna open it up a bunch of times. This is how you crash a server. Yeah. So that's what I'm doing right now is I'll show you. So this is a delete, control S, and you should just be Steel City Squadron. So I'm doing like a credits kind of thing here, and that's point is all the players that will be streamed or anyone who participated, or like for CAC per se, I'm going to put a lot of the sponsors' names on here. And then, you know, it's kind of a credit thing because, you know, even though I'm doing this or someone else is doing this with me, they got to get the credit. That's how I feel. You know, that's one of my favorite things about the community of X-Wing. There's a lot of positivity, a lot of work, a lot of people doing a lot of stuff together. So very happy about that kind of stuff. So, you know, if you have any recommendations, or honestly, if you know how to do some better software editing or graphic interface, that would be great. Get in touch with me. I'm trying to learn this stuff on my own. I have been just kind of winging it for most cases. But again, this is what I want a full game to be. I want us to be able to go through here and be like, okay, let's go to the live game screen. All right, this is your standard screen. It gives you a lot of view. I got to figure out how I'm going to do a ton of lights, or I got to make sure there is enough lighting. This is the screen that I want to kind of use when the players are setting their dials, because I feel like, and I want to jump between it, because this is, again, standard. This gives you a pretty good view, but like, I play a lot on Vassal, and I like this over-the-top angle. It might give me a better insight in terms of, hey, look, this player, and I'm working on the teleprompter portion, this player, you know, they should have gone to the right, you know. I think it'll be easier for a teleprompter kind of setup. I'm kind of working on that one. OBS doesn't have a built-in thing. Probably going to try something on XSplit for a little bit. I got a few weeks free with that, and that has a built-in one. So I want to see it. I think things are transferable. And then I also got to figure out an offline method of doing this, because I'm terrible at video editing, and I want to be able to have this detail on here even when we're playing offline, record, let it go. I am learning Python. I'm still learning it. I believe I can do this all in Python because OBS and Python have a good talk together. I'm just trying to get that figured out. So if I can take the stream tabletop feature, basically put a localized version of it on here, which I had. I know a few other languages, and the one I was working in, I did it as a test, and it was cool, but, I mean, yeah, you guys look at my earlier videos. It's kind of a mess at times. It doesn't show all the information. I like being able to see those cards and stuff. So if I could have that locally saved, I'd be all for that. But yeah, so That's what that is. So, like I said, I'm just going to get back in. So I'm going to turn off the commentator mic. I'm going to turn the dice tray mic on, and I'm not going to really set those dials for that list in the corner there. I'm going to try and jump around. I'll try and actually track everything through here. I don't have the cards out. I'm being lazy for now. But, you know, like I said, if you want to see some more live games, I can do them from home. No problem. And I like playing live. I like playing Vassal. And, you know, I'll try and get some people here, and we can maybe play live games there. If I'm trying to figure out how to do a community versus me setup, so I'll let you guys vote on each list, what they should be doing, who they should be attacking, and I give, like, a, you know, 10-second window or something like that. I want to try and do that, because I think it'd be cool, like, you know, we get, like, 5 or 6 viewers here at a time. Let's get a community kind of thing going on. So let you guys play against me. You know, that's another reason why I like this overhead cam. Might be a little bit easier, and I can correct certain things, or, you know, let someone else pick the movements. I don't know. We'll figure it out. Okay, good. I was afraid that I just had that all turned off. But okay, switching over to the dice.
Dice tray mic is now on that screen. Dice tray mic is now on in this screen. And okay, cool. All right, so I am going to speak a little bit louder. Hopefully it's coming in a little clearer and things are okay. Just want to, I know this is randomly at night, so I'm going to have someone else double check. All right, sorry. So, let's see how this goes. Okay, so I'm going to try and set some dials here for these guys. I got to learn their. I'm just going to kind of practice them for a little bit here. You know, again, one thing I want to talk about is not really the list per se, but more along the lines of understanding my engagement timing window, these, how you fly these guys. All right. All right, so, all right, my opponent's list is 3s and 4s, and this is a 5-5-5 list. Now, I've faced this before, and it is a pain. It's an absolute pain. Yeah, so that's why I've faced this before. I'm just trying to bounce between things here and there. So, okay, all right. So, I would assume my opponent essentially does this. The wings are open. I think it's all about just. Everyone's focusing up. Now, I've flown a variation of this list. I love the B-wings. I really do. I actually really like the Ace B-wings more than anything. I think they're awesome. I think they're really clever. You get to use them in a unique way. So I believe that is important. All right. Okay. So then, there was a ball of focus, and then I did two straights with all these guys, but I got Duchess. I don't need these adaptive aerons. Okay. Now I gotta do a better job here about something. So I'm measuring range here. Now obviously amount. But the factor is, where can I be and where can he be on that next round? So if we're both here, you know, he moves up. So what would it take? So like if I do a one, which I can't do. So let me, if I did three. I mean, the tide bands can do it, but this represents doing a two, and my ship is now at three. At the end of the top of it will be at three. So at three, I'm still out if he doesn't move. But that means, okay, so if he did one, set up in that kind of formation, I gotta get, all right. So the one maneuver would give me one of his ships. I'd be firing at range three. I'd be taking shots now based on it, this being a base and a half. I'd be taking shots from all three lift. All four? And again, this is assuming that he goes as slow as he does. That's actually kind of important. I probably shouldn't have messed that one up. Yeah. That would actually leave out the back B wing. Knowing that, he might actually go a little faster because he needs all four guns every time shooting against this kind of lit. Eventually, the dice go out. The vague dice do go out there. So I gotta think that one through. I do like that overhead. I have a little cut off. That's going to be all a game of figuring out what fits best, but that's, I don't know, kind of happy about it. Also, you guys can't see it, let me go, like, so this is a table I have down here in my house. Now, it fits the map very well, it fits the cameras, it fits the dice tray, it fits that well. I'm working on building something. I want to build a stream of my X-Wing table, okay? I can have a seam like that. That seam is so invisible here. Here's the seam you don't even feel it on the game. So that's the kind of seam I want to get if I have to fold. Ideally, I want to have a folding table to make things easier. This is excess space. I don't want excess space, and I know this isn't that important. I need space here because I want the players to have cards. Now, question is, do I have an uplift in middle region? Probably not. That gets a little hard, tough with this, because if I wanted to fold. Do I have a built-in dice tray? I think so. That might be what I go for, so the table is probably going to be thicker, and then the dice tray is built into it. That might be nice. And then, I can have basically pegs to hold in everything. I don't know. I gotta be thinking about. All right. Let me see here. Okay. All right, and thanks to the Steel City Squadron guys, I asked them to jump on to take a couple look here, so appreciate that. Super helpful. I'm seeing I'm having some issues, but okay. But yeah, I mean, I might be able to set this up eventually. If I play live here, I can export this all out. Maybe I gotta figure out maybe what I'm uploading at when I'm on this camera. I believe there we go. I think this might actually be uploading a little bit better, the upload speed wise. I don't know. I'm still, again, learning all this stuff. Okay. Back to the game here. The Duchess is out here. Oh, yeah, that's cool. So this is Duchess. This is Merrick. This is Scourge. This is Mahler. This is Hal. You know, obviously Duchess being out way out there. So if I do my threes, I can fire everything into either Cassian. Let's, or if I do my two straight, so let's just see. This is the whole point of this is, can I just joust this with this kind of list? Because I have out initiative him. If I stay at range three, that might help me the most. And I'd probably do, like, if it's set up something like that, I want to do a one boost forward. Oh, and then what's that dial? Alright, so let me see. This is a TIE-LN, TIE-LN, TIE-Vance. Of course, it's the last one. Get the two. Please don't wear a mat. Two bank makes a lot of sense. What about the three bank? And I'm not assuming everything. Yeah, see, that's why. Three bank would have fit. Set me up for an interesting round next turn. Say I did that. Okay, so I'm all fives. Alright, so let's do Howl Runner in the back here. I'm just going to measure. Okay, so Howl Runner would be out. Not terrible. So this is Mahler. Mahler is only rolling two. My opponent's rolled 3.
Hey, wow. Alright, so there's that. And probably spend the focus. Not take anything. Okay. Now.
Surge. Back. Surge. In bullseye. Range 3, I get 3, they get 3, so that's what I'm going at for with Scourge.
You know, Howl Runner, and spend my focus. And crits are really bad for me here. Okay, so then that would be two shields onto, who's it? That's Cassian. Or that's actually Magma, sorry. So, let's get that updated. That'd be both shields. I don't know if he selflesses that. Let's assume no decision making on that one. Okay. Mr. Merrick. 3v3 again. Or 2v3. I don't have the target lock. See, I just focused. Howl Runner. And then 2v3. Hey, I would, if I'm him at that point, Cassian might take that shield just because you start reducing the damage. I don't know. We'll have to see. Okay, and then Duchess. Yeah, that actually is kind of stupid of me there. So I'd go into Cassian here. In bullseye at range 3. I get 3. He gets 3. Oh. Let's just say it's invaded. Okay, so it's safe. Alright. That's the thing I'm going for. Okay, and then they shoot back. This would be 10. He might have focused and barreled. Yeah, he probably failed the barrel. Him, I'm going for Mauler, I think. So, 3v4. 10 numbs ability. Spend in the stress. And save. Braylon doesn't have a shot because I have him in the back there. I don't know if he would actually fly it that way, but I'm just kind of setting it up. Knowing how he flies, I think he actually does a whole barrel roll and gets it, and they're all kind of lined up, but this is just the way, again, I'm just trying to see. So, magma shots, same thing, range 3, 3v4. Now, let's just assume the worst every time. Hey, a shield, or it'd be a haul off of, say that's Mauler. So I don't think he'd go for Merrick. And then Cassian, same shots. Spend it. Ooh, make it worse. Ooh. And throw die off there. Hey, I'm taking a crit too. So we're just going to assume for the sake of just not getting cards, I'm not going to do that. So. Again, just kind of practicing out. My Mauler, oh man, he got this. He has the lead right now. In this case, I would say. Even though trying to set up an engage tree. So maybe I do a target lock here instead. Alright, and then him. Got Leia, he can throw all these zeros. Braylon gets his stress removed. You know. They can do the 3 straight. And that's what I would do. I'd try to cause as much bumps as possible. And that's where I don't want to be at.
So like, isn't like, okay, now I have two straights with all these guys. That causes a massive bump. That's a bunch of bad news for me, especially if I want to take out one of the U links first. That would be bad. This is where I ideally want to be if I'm. This is the real engagement round. Like the, I want to be range one with everyone here, okay? Like if I actually ended up my turn and just be out there and howling in the back. I mean the point of this list, the way it's set up, is you're trying to maximize. So like Mahler Mythler, okay, range one. Now four dice. Howlrunner. Spend the focus. And then casting or magma ho, like I'll crack shot you. And then he takes spend gets a Selfless is helping him there. Scourge, same thing. Four dice. Howlrunner. Spend the focus. Cassian or the U-Wing. Okay, I don't have to crack shot. That's good solid damage through that time. Merrick, who should target lock, so that it's four dice. And then. Okay. Oh. No point not to, so spend the target lock. Okay, so it'd be three. And if I'd had it, but I don't think I would have it in this case. And like Merrick could be here. I gotta figure out what I'm gonna do with that, but let's say it's not. So it's only one damage through, and then Duchess. Now I'm trying to say, let's say it's only three dice this time, like a range two shot. And not enough to. And if he spends it, and I had lined up, like if I just did a. Because if I'm here, I wouldn't, personally, him, I wouldn't go for Duchess. But I do that. So, like, that gives me the crack shot at range two. Right? Ooh, Mackinac, yeah. Well, I play on Bass, folks. Okay. So that would give me that crack shot. It's an interesting. I'm working on it. I'm working on it. I know that. I hope it's coming in clear. I think oh, that's annoying, that glare from the phone. But I appreciate everyone joining in, taking a look at this. This is just a real test again. A little choppy, I'm seeing it coming through. I don't know why. I'm plugged in Ethernet cable wise. Okay, so for video recording purposes and stuff, this is being recorded, so it should. I'll probably move and transfer this to YouTube if it isn't choppy. I'll watch it later on here. But yeah, so let me cut back to here. This. Okay, so thanks again for joining. If this is coming in pretty well, then I hope it is. I hope it's not too messed up. But again, we'll try and maybe set up some more live games, actually visible, working properly. I wonder if it's that port. I don't know. Either way, big message: support CAC. That's the most important thing. Guys, do what you can to support CAC. And I hope to see everyone local here that can make it at the event. I'll be running it. We'll be streaming it. Hopefully, it's coming in. It'll come in nice and clear. No issues there. Either way, we'll get it uploaded so you guys can enjoy it. We got a lot of awesome prizes. We got a lot of awesome stuff. League games, we're gonna just record them because where we play, they can't come in clear, which is a darn shame, but
it is what it is. So not much else I can do about that. So hopefully we will, get those uploaded, and then we'll get commentary from the players. I might rewatch them and upload them on YouTube or here later. If I do that, that'll be kind of cool, because they'll be like, I'll try and commentate for them. Some of them I remember watching, some of them I don't. So, thanks again. Have a good one, and I gotta figure out how to fly a list. Empire. I don't know. I don't like flying them. Again, if I can set up the live game community setup, let me know. We'll play it. Or if you want to play me on Vassal, message me here, and we'll talk soon. So, again, a short stream, but thanks again.